And hello, everyone. Excuse me. How are you all doing? Here we are with our second video in the Let's Play Mass Effect 2 series. In the first video, we found out we saw the Normandy get destroyed. She looked like Shepard died, but Cerberus brought him back to life. We met Miranda. We met Jacob. We can see the scientists over there doing their thing. And we met the Illusive Man in that little room over there to the right of that wall panel. And he asked us to go to Freedom's Progress to check it out, see what's going on. So, got a level up, got a couple points. Really? Okay, this I didn't know. Let me see. Received. Started at level 3 instead of level 1 because importing a huge level 59 character into Mass Effect 2. Extra credits, extra resources, Paragon points, 100,000 extra bonus credits. Because remember, I had technically over 10 million. Credits in the Mass Effect 1 playthrough. Because I beat the game already, I got an extra 200,000 credits to start, 50,000 of the resource, and a 25% bonus experience for all the missions. So, and then of course we got the grenade launcher. Okay. So, we will now head to Freedom's Progress.
We should be there shortly, Shepard. The Illusive Man put us under your command. Do you have any orders?
Just keep your eyes open. We're looking for anything that tells us who did this.
Understood, Commander. With luck, we'll find something that was missed at the other colonies.
Then we can find out who's behind it and get some payback.
Okay. Now, let's see. See, Shepard. No points, that's fine. Increase Jacob's health and weapon damage. Miranda. Put a couple points into the. Increase her health, weapon damage, and all that, and I will use Miranda. Is one of the main companions. Let's see. Then, greater overload. Okay. Now for weapons. She's got the machine pistol, and Jacob's got the shotgun. I've got the pistol, shotgun, assault rifle, sniper rifle, and grenade launcher. But the excuse me, assault rifle for now. And okay, that and that. Okay, let's see what we can. Things going.
Looks like everyone just got up and left right in the middle of dinner.
Turn it up a little more for you. Make sure we didn't miss anything. Excuse me.
Okay. Strange. No bodies, no structural damage, and no signs of battle.
Any salvage or anything you got, you pick up, will automatically be become credits. sniper rifle I like to use, or the assault rifle I like to use.
Someone reprogrammed them to attack on sight. We're not alone here.
For synthetics, you want to go with the blue, the disruptor ammo, or the, I forget what it's called. In Mass Effect 1, the one I mostly used. Okay, let's get to see. This is a little hacking minigame. So it's not really hacking. More money. Okay.
We've been spotted!
Shields are failed!
Stop right there!
Praza, you said you'd let me handle this. Wait, Shepard?
I'm not taking any chances with Cerberus operatives.
Put those weapons down! Shepard? Is that... you're alive?
Cerberus rebuilt me, Tally. In return, they asked me to investigate these attacks on human colonies.
You'll pardon us for not taking you at your word, Cerberus.
We're well within our rights to investigate attacks on a human colony. I'd like to know what the Quarians are doing here.
Weapons down, Praza. Whatever's going on here, I don't think we need another fight. One of our people was here on pilgrimage. His name was Vitor. We came to find him.
If Vitor survived the attack, he may be able to tell us what happened.
That's the hope. We've seen him, but he might not be in the best state to answer questions. He was injured and, nervous around...
She means that he was unstable. Combine that with damage to his soot CO2 scrubbers and an infection from an open-air exposure, and he's likely delirious.
When he saw us landing, he hid in a warehouse on the far side of town. We suspect he also programmed the mechs to attack anything that moved.
Vitor's the only one who can tell us what happened here. We should work together to find him.
Good idea. You'll need two teams to get past the drones anyway.
Now we're working with Cerberus?
No, Praza. You're working for me. If you can't follow orders, go wait on the ship. Head for the warehouse through the center of the colony. We'll circle around the far side and draw off some of the drones to clear you a path.
Make sure to keep in radio contact.
Will do. Good luck, Shepard. See you on the far side.
Okay.
Be careful, Shepard. There's a squad of security drones up ahead.
Thanks for the warning. We'll take care of them.
We're compromised. Here goes.
Still catch them.
Here
we go.
Hurry, Shepard. We are inside the loading docks. Vitor reprogrammed the heavy mech. It's tearing Fraza's squad apart.
They did want to get to Vito first.
Get your squad into cover and I'll open the loading bay doors.
Taking cover! One tough son of a bitch to take down.
While I tend to the wounded, Shepard. He's probably somewhere in the back of the loading bay.
Scan the mech.
This is coming handy.
Ah, increased heavy weapon ammo.
Monsters coming back. The mechs will protect. Safe from swarms. Have to hide. No monsters. No swarms. No.
Vitor?
No, Vitor. Not here. Swarms can't find. Monsters coming. Have to hide.
Nobody's gonna hurt you anymore.
I don't think he can hear you, Commander.
Have to hide. Mechs will protect. Human, where did you hide? How come they didn't find you?
Who didn't find us?
The monsters, the swarms. They took everyone.
Why didn't the colonists fight back, Vitor? What happened?
You don't know. You didn't see. But I see everything.
Looks like security footage. He must have pieced it together manually.
What the hell is that?
My God. I think it's a collector.
Is that some kind of alien?
They're a species from somewhere beyond the Omega 4 relay. Only a few people have ever seen one in person.
They usually work through intermediaries, like slavers or hired mercenaries. If they're involved with the Reapers somehow, it could explain what happened to the colonies.
The collectors have advanced technology. They could have a weapon that disables an entire settlement at once.
The Seeker swarms. No one can hide. The Seekers find you, freeze you, then the monsters take you away.
What happened next?
The monsters took the people onto the ship, and then they left. The ship flew away. But they'll be back for me. No one escapes.
I think that's probably all we're getting out of him, Commander.
We appreciate what you told us. You were very helpful.
I studied them. The monsters. The swarms. I recorded them with my Omni tool. Lots of readings. Electromagnetic. Dark energy.
We need to get this data to the Illusive Man. Grab the Quarren and call the shuttle to come pick us up.
What? Vitor is injured. He needs treatment, not an interrogation.
We won't hurt him. We just need to see if he knows anything else. He'll be returned unharmed.
Your people tried to betray us once already. If we give him to you, we'll never get the intel we need.
Praza was an idiot, and he and his men paid for it. You're welcome to take Vitor's Omnitool data, but please, just let me take him.
He's traumatized and he needs medical care. Callie will give us the Omnitool data and take him to the flotilla.
Understood, Commander.
Thank you, Shepard. I'm glad you're still the one giving the orders. Good luck out there. If I find anything that can help you, I'll let you know.
We're ready for pickup.
Shepard, good work on Freedom's Progress. The Quarians forwarded their findings from Vitor's debriefing. No new data, but it's a surprising olive branch given our history. You and I have different methods, but I can't argue with your results.
You ever think about playing nice once in a while?
Diplomacy is great when it works, but difficult when everyone already perceives you as a threat. But more importantly, you confirm the Collectors are behind the abductions.
Why do I get the feeling you knew about them already?
I had my suspicions, but I needed proof. The Collectors are enigmatic at best. They periodically travel to the Terminus systems, looking to gather seemingly unimportant items or specimens, usually in exchange for their technology. When their transactions are complete, they disappear as quickly as they arrive, back beyond the unmapped Omega 4 relay. Until now, we've had no evidence of direct aggression by the Collectors.
Why is the Omega 4 relay unmapped? What do we know about it?
Only that no ship passing through it has ever returned. Our best guess is that the relay reacts differently to Collector vessels, allowing them safe passage. If they can manipulate relays, that's just further evidence of the connection with the Reapers.
Any ideas on why they've shifted their focus to humans?
If they're agents for the Reapers, it could be any number of reasons. Obviously, humanity played a huge role in Sovereign's destruction. That might have been enough to draw their attention. What really concerns me is why they bother abducting the colonists. Once the humans are paralyzed, why not just kill them?
You're holding something back. How do you know the Reapers are involved?
The patterns are there, buried in the data. The Council and the Alliance want to believe the Reaper threat died with Sovereign. You and I know better. I will wait until the Reapers are on the march. We need to take the fight to them.
I hate waiting, but I'll need a team. A good one.
I've already compiled a list of soldiers, scientists, and mercenaries. You'll get dossiers on the best of them. Finding them and convincing them to work with you could be challenging, but you're a natural leader. I'll continue to track the Collectors. When they make their next appearance, I'll notify you and your team. Be ready.
You worry about the Collectors. I'll make sure my team's ready.
Good. Two things before you go. First, head to Omega and find Morden Solis. He's a brilliant Solarian scientist. Our intelligence suggests he may know how to counteract the Collector's paralyzing seeker swarms.
Sounds good. What else?
I found a pilot I think you might like. I hear he's one of the best. Someone you can trust.
Look who it is.
Hey, Commander. Just like old times, huh?
I can't believe it's you, Joker.
Look who's talking. I saw you get spaced.
Got lucky, with a lot of strings attached. How'd you get here?
It all fell apart without you, Commander. Everything you stirred up, the Council just wanted it gone. The team was broken up, record sealed, and I was grounded. The Alliance took away the one thing that mattered to me. Hell yeah, I joined Cerberus.
You really trust the Illusive Man?
Well, I don't trust anyone who makes more than I do. But they aren't all bad. It saved your life, let me fly, and there's this. They only told me last night.
We'll be right back.
Okay. Well, let's go ahead and explore the Normandy.
Use some type of advanced technology to immobilize their victims. We'll need him to develop a countermeasure to protect us.
Without that countermeasure, we'll be helpless if we ever run into the collectors.
Acquiring Professor Solis seems like the most logical place to start.
Who are you?
I'm the Normandy's artificial intelligence. The crew like to refer to me as Edie.
This is what I was talking about in the video in Mass Effect 1 where we went to the moon and took care of that rogue VI. Cerberus took that rogue VI and turned it into Edie.
Helmsmen aren't happy when someone takes control of a ship away from them. Especially Joker.
I do not helm the ship. Mr. Moreau's talents will not go to waste. During combat, I operate the electronic warfare and cyber warfare suites. Beyond that, I cannot interface with the ship's systems. I observe and offer analysis and advice. Nothing more.
I'm guessing it takes more than just the three of us plus Joker to fly this ship.
The Normandy has a full crew. They're at their stations awaiting your orders.
Final preparations for takeoff are complete, Commander. When you're ready to go, just pick a destination from the galaxy map and the CIC and I'll plot a course.
Jacob and I should return to our posts. Come find us if you have any questions.
Mm-hmm. Private terminal, yep, the armory, yep. Elevator, captain's quarters, yada yada yada, tech lab, I gotta get Morden for that. That's why we will go get Morden first. Okay. Okay, we go here, and I can select, let's see, the Matok, the M96 Matok heavy rifle. It's considered a, but it's a semi-automatic. Oh, I love this thing. It's awesome. Go take that one for now. Just for now. Take the phalanx and the arc projector. Good for, synthetics. No, private terminal. Let's see. Oop, I didn't want to do that. Grids. Don't see that yet. Any messages from Counselor Anderson? On the off chance that the rumors are true and you actually are alive, I need you to come and talk to me on the Citadel. A lot has changed in the last 2 years. You put me on the council, and it's only fair that you be allowed to speak for yourself about what we've been hearing. This one is just about one of the DLCs. We've reached a group from the Illusive Man, blah blah blah. That one is also part of a DLC. This one, we can go back to the site of where the Normandy was attacked at the beginning of the game, and go through that. Those two different armors. This is one of the DLCs as well. Arc projector, just got that. Kasumi, that's also as DLC, and then the weapons we talked about, and I think that's it.
Welcome aboard, Commander. I'm Yeoman Kelly Chambers. I've been assigned as your administrative assistant. I'll manage your messages and help you monitor the crew. And I must say, it's such an honor to work under you, Commander Shepard.
I'm glad to have you on the team, Miss Chambers.
Please, call me Kelly.
Okay, Kelly.
Anything else?
Is there anything I should know?
Joker would like to speak to you on the bridge. Anything else, Commander?
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Okay. We'll talk to Joker, and then we'll head to Omega to Morden Solis.
Can you believe this, Commander? It's my baby! Better than new! It fits me like a glove! And leather seats! Military may set the hardware standard, but on a first-gen frigate, they could care less if the seats breathe. Civilian sector comfort by design.
Reproduction is not intended to be perfect, Mr. Moreau. Seamless improvements were made.
And there's the downside. I liked the Normandy when she was beautiful and quiet. Now she's got this thing I don't want to talk about. It's like ship cancer.
Enjoy it, Joker. If we're stuck here, we might as well let them pamper us.
Does it breach uniform regs if I get that on a crew shirt? Because this is my favorite. You have no choice. Choice ever.
Technically, this is a civilian ship. I'm probably lucky you're still wearing pants.
Yeah, I'll save that for the off-hour cameras. Have an AI watch me 24/7. Cheers.
Let's talk to Edie.
Yes, Shepard.
I want to know more about you.
Do you have a specific inquiry?
How are you getting along with Joker?
Mr. Moreau does not trust me. It offends him that I am installed aboard his ship's computers.
Yeah, the last Normandy did just fine without an AI reminding me the airlock is ajar.
Why are you named Edie?
Edie is the phonetic pronunciation of E-D-I. That is an acronym for Enhanced Defense Intelligence.
Where are you?
My core intelligence is housed in a quantum blue box located behind the medical bay.
What do you do aboard the ship?
I operate the ship's electronic and cyber warfare suites in combat. My reaction time is much faster than any organic. I collate the records of shipboard monitoring devices for the Illusive Man. I serve additional functions which are restricted at this time.
Restricted functions? Like what?
I do not know. Some of my databases are sealed. Some of my hardware is kept offline. I assume that when certain unknown conditions are met, those functions will be released to me.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
Okay, you know what, that's a pretty decent, going for probably about a, close to a half hour, it's pretty good. We went ahead and helped Freedom's Progress, reported the Elusive Man, met the new Normandy, or just the Normandy, talked to Joker, and that's good. We'll go ahead and put our marker there, and then in the next video, we'll go to Omega and find Dr. Solis. That'll be the next video, but in the meantime, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you all soon.